Yo, what's up, man? This is your host, Ricky Klein, the Cassette Master, coming at you again on the Flat Earth. And I want to give another presentation of another tape recorder. It's been quite a while since I've been giving some presentations. I did do a video recently of my friend Dan Beard talking on a Pierce wire recorder with the wire recording of his synchronized with the video. And I'm going to be doing some more videos soon, don't worry. There'll be a presentation on the wire recorder. There's going to be another wire recorder as well, shown soon. And there's other machines, lined up too. Well, in this video, it's going to be a very special device. It's going to be a microcassette recorder. It's been a while since I made a video on a microcassette recorder. I did make a video on a mini cassette machine made by IBM, but that was already over a year ago, which, how does time go by this fast? Who knows, man? But it's been a while since I made a video on a micro cassette recorder. I don't do too much with micro cassettes. Of course, my favorite is portable reel-to-reel machines, and there will be another portable reel-to-reel video coming at some point. But, and of course, I also have a thing for wire recorders, but this video is going to be on a microcassette recorder. Now, this isn't your average microcassette recorder, and you're about to see why. Because most microcassette recorders, you see, you hold it in your hand. It's a little small contraption you hold up to your mouth and take little notes, little dictations, or you stick it on your desk to record your college lectures. Well, at least back before the days when everything went digital. But rarely do you see larger microcassette machines, save for the occasional transcription machines, which typically would plug into the wall and were a lot larger, and some of them had nice big speakers, and that is big in comparison to your typical microcassette recorder speaker, and much better sound quality. But this one is in between. This is not one of those handheld, put-it-up-to-your-mouth microcassette recorders, and nor is it a transcription machine, although it is somewhere close. It is running on battery or AC. It is the Panasonic something or other microcassette recorder, the RQ-195. Microcassette recorder from the 1970s. I think this one, if I remember correctly, the date inside on the motor is 1978. Or was it 76? I think it's 78. This is a very interesting recorder because this is pretty darn big for a microcassette recorder. And the thing is it is the size that you would expect a standard cassette machine to be. Yet instead, it's for a microcassette. I mean, look at this thing up close. The size of the buttons not only are the size for a standard shoebox cassette recorder's buttons, but they're even the right amount of spacing that you could put a regular standard cassette in the area where your microcassette and counter are, and it looks like it'd be just the right size for a regular cassette recorder, but instead, it's a microcassette recorder, and also, I am talking funny on purpose, because it's fun. It's a two-speed machine, and it also boasts pitch control. Now, you'll notice here the remote pause. It's all blurry, but, well, not anymore, but the remote pause here, it looks like something is missing from there. And I thought something might have been missing. Well, actually, it's a remote mechanical pause. There would be a special jack of sorts that would go in there. I don't have that jack. It probably would have gone to a foot pedal or a remote start-stop, except it actually mechanically pushes the mechanical pause mechanism inside. So you'd actually have a remote switch that would mechanically transfer the motion of pushing it into the recorder to actually activate the mechanical pause, which is very interesting. This thing is, of course, AC bias. It has pretty good sound quality, as you would expect. If I remember correctly off the data sheet or off the, I saw a picture of the manual. I think it's the frequency response, I think, went down to 200 hertz, I think. Or was it 100 hertz? I don't even remember for sure. It might have been down to one. Actually, I think it went down to 100 hertz at the low end. And then the high end was 7 kilohertz. Of course, this is at the standard 2.4 centimeters per second speed, which 7 kilohertz at 15, 16 inches per second is pretty darn good.
The tube is coming squeaking again. Not good. Oh, boom, that is not good at all. This is a microcassette recorder, and I have to say I am very impressed with the quality of this unit. This is a microcassette recording at the speed of 1.2 centimeters per second. The slow speed or long play speed on a microcassette. This is a microcassette recording at the speed of 1.2 centimeters per second. The slow speed or long play speed on a microcassette. This tape recorder is from the year 1978, and today's date is the 21st of July, 2020. The world is ending, am I right? We're back at the standard speed of 2.4 centimeters per second on this microcassette. Am I right?
Being recorded?
Testing 1, 2, 3. This is a recording with a built-in microphone. Testing. Hello.
So I thought I recorded music at half speed, but I couldn't have been farther from the truth. Which is confusing because I know I did. I bet my life on it I did. I got 3 minutes of battery on the camera now. It's taking its toll. Oh. Man! Q just increases the speed. By the way, there's mechanical pause. The beauty of this mechanical pause is, watch this. Yeah, I'm sticking a screwdriver in here. I'm just pushing the little lever. Charge the battery pack!
We just fight.
Oh boy, dead man.
Now it's taking its toll.
First recording on this cassette in 2020. It is July, holy crap, excuse me for a second. July 16th, 2020. I'm using a different recorder I just acquired off eBay. It is a Panasonic model
RQ-195 microcassette recorder, but it is the size of a standard cassette recorder. Now I am using an external microphone, the Sony F96 microphone, with the RQ-195, or switch to half speed.
Now we're recording at 1.2
centimeters per second on the Panasonic RQ-195, 1.2 centimeters per second, switch back. Now we're recording again at the standard speed of, or the faster speed, of 2.4 centimeters per second on a microcassette. They like to use metric with the microcassette. This is the same as 15/16 inches per second.
On here at half speed. Quick deal. When you cue.
Wait, is this being recorded?
Yes.
Just recently, like the other day.
Is that all?
When you cue, it raises the motor speed, okay? Review is a mechanical fast review, but cue raises the motor speed and does not release the pinch roller. However, regular fast forward without playing actually does a mechanical fast forward. Now we'll be recording music at half speed on this machine. We use an attenuator, of course, because we don't want to, well, it's only had a microphone input, so if we put a line level on there, it's just going to overdrive the amplifier and distort. We don't want any of that nonsense, so, I mean, it's got ALC, but it doesn't want a line level input. We're just going to put a little bit, some of this song here, Maritime Tatimi by Victrola, kind of a part that I really, really like of this song here. Towards the end, it just starts getting really, 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 really good, and just recording some of it on microcassette at half speed. Record and play go down together when you push. If you just push on record, the both buttons go down together, but I like to put my finger in the middle so it doesn't stress the mechanism that pushes this, the one down with it. To record, it turns a light on, and then we'll start playing the music, and it's gonna go on to the tape. Then we'll rewind and play back.
Thank you.
And finally, we will do direct connection from this microcassette recorder's output to be able to listen to it direct. I hope you enjoy. Yeah, baby. The type is coming squeaking again. Not good. Yo, boom, that is not good at all. This is a microcassette recorder, and I have to say I am very impressed with the quality of this unit.
This is a microcassette recording at the speed of 1.2 centimeters per second.
The quality of this unit.
This is a microcassette recording at the speed of 1.2 centimeters per second. The slow speed or long play speed on a microcassette. This tape recorder is from the year 1978, and today's date is the 21st of July, 2020. The world is ending, am I right? Speed of 2.4 centimeters per second on this microcassette, am I right?
Cue this tape here, try to find the half speed.
Hey, wait, is this being recorded?
Yes. Okay, here we go. Yes, man. Here I am again. I hope you enjoyed this video shot on the flat earth of the Panasonic jumbo size microcassette recorder. Very unusual for the microcassette format. I know it may be a little tape, but it's a big recorder. I hope you enjoyed this. Oh, my leveling is so crap. Actually, no, the levels look all right. Oh, well. It probably sounds bad on the camera, though, am I right? It's kind of sad. The output, you know what I mean? Well, actually, the output goes through a thing that turns the balanced to an unbalanced. It's just that I fade it straight into the mic input of the camera without an attenuator first. So if it sounds like you know what, you know why. You have watched a Cougar presentation. The computer, Windows 98. Oh, yeah.
This has been a cassette.